Lynda Cromar coming to you from Colorado, and it's gorgeous here, and I wanted to share some thoughts with you this morning. You know, we can do a lot of how-tos, but you know what comes first is how you feel inside and how your heart is feeling. And today, you see my profile there, and I'm leaving it there for a few seconds just so that you can see how you can connect with me, because I really believe that's important. Connect with each other as entrepreneurs so that we can help each other, support each other, make each other feel good, and give support when there are nobody else around that can. Other entrepreneurs definitely are going to understand you better than anybody. Good morning. How are you? And thanks so much for coming. And I love the hearts. I actually thrive on the hearts. So the more of those you give, the better. I'll probably just go off on a great big rant and just help you feel good about where you're coming from. Now, one thing I wanted to share with you, and you probably don't know this. Thanks for coming. Actually, this is a great turnout. Thanks. You probably don't know this, and this might help you out a little bit, but my husband is not necessarily a very supportive person. Now, he doesn't mean to be, but he's just doing the best he can to, you know, kind of keep it all going in his family, you know, in his way of supporting. And you got to realize some people support differently than others, is that he brings in the money because, of course, my income isn't yet at the place where it's going to cover everybody and all of the stuff we need to do. Oh, thanks a lot. Come on in and have fun. We're going to enjoy this. But anyway, what happens when you don't have the support at home that you need to have, and you really, more than anything else, you want that spouse or that significant other or that daughter or that son, you want them to actually want to believe in you, and it's really hard when they don't. Now, I had an experience just recently. Yes, hello, thanks for coming. I had a experience just recently that my daughter, and she was not really private about it. You know, she could have done a phone call, wouldn't have been very pleasant, but instead she did a Facebook message and basically kind of raked me over the coals for all the things that she thought I did wrong as a mother. Now, she's not 40 yet, and her kids are teenagers, so she's going through some pretty big trials with them. And one thing I learned a long time ago is you can't control anybody but yourself, right? You really can't. Even with kids, they're going to have their own mind. And even when you think you have rules at work, a lot of the time, they're going to buck those rules. They're going to try to do their own thing. And she's starting to realize that, I think, with her 16-year-old. She's got two of them in her household. And it's really tough sometimes when, but that particular conversation was really painful. And the reason why, no, they're not. I'm just using them for reading because my eyes are a little older and I want to be able to see all of your comments. And if I don't put on my glasses, I can't see your comments. And I really want to be able to see that. So hi from Brooklyn and thanks for that comment. And so my husband also, his attitude is, I hope you can do it. And that's just about the tone he uses. So that doesn't leave a lot of confidence if that's the only people in your life that you're listening to. And it's really tough as an entrepreneur for you to keep feeling like you're in the right direction, you're doing what you need to do. I am an internet marketer. I help people learn how to market online. That's what I do. So what is really needs to change is that you need to have a community that you're with, that you feel good about being with, that they can give you the encouragement that you might not be getting at home. Because if you're only dealing with what your husband says or what your daughter says or what your son says or what some of your friends that you're involved with say, that's going to make you discouraged. Well, let's get together. You can connect with me on Facebook later. Definitely, So what you want to do, associations are absolutely so imperative. And so your associations with other entrepreneurs that are building something, it doesn't have to be that they're in your same company. It can be just like right now, the people right here in this Periscope, you're all in different things, and it's great. We can all share that one part of it is that we all need to be supportive of each other because most of the time, I actually, most of the time, until you reach a certain income level, you might not have a lot of belief because we're always teaching you have to believe before you see it. But what does the world teach? The world teaches you have to see it before you believe it. So we all have, yes, we do, Jim. We have a common interest, and it's so important that we support each other. Even if we're in different companies, never tear each other down, if we don't believe in that company. No, everybody's got good stuff. So, yeah, you've got a wife that supports you. You are blessed. You are blessed because that is such a big thing to have somebody that actually just says, go for it, that believes in you, that they may not understand your business, they may not understand what you're doing, but they still stand behind you. Now, my husband doesn't keep me from working at what I'm doing, but he doesn't exactly understand what I'm doing either. And he doesn't exactly believe in what I'm doing because he hasn't seen enough steady success yet. That doesn't mean it won't happen, and I definitely believe it'll happen. I have no problem believing that it will happen. It's lonely at the glass art world. Oh, okay. Is that where you work? Yeah. And so you want your family, and when we get involved with something like this, you want your family to believe in you more than anything else. And that's often the hardest place because they've seen everything that you've done. They've seen the ups and downs. They've seen the failures. They've seen the failed businesses. They've seen the money lost. And they pay attention to more of the negative side of things than they do to the positive. So you have to give them a little bit of slack. So I don't have an argument with my husband about whether or not he believes in me. I don't go into that. So, what can you do to be positive with that spouse, no matter what? Because you've made a commitment, right? My marriage matters, and of course, I've made a commitment, and I believe in that. And so, absolutely, you support them all you can. You thank them. You know what? I have gone out of my way to say thank you even more so lately, because one thing that I love is that he gets up. And he goes to work like clockwork every single day, almost every single day. I've never hardly seen him take a sick day. So, yes, you have to believe in that, in the little things they do, and pay attention to those instead of the things that might be negative. Because you know what? The more you say, I appreciate you, oh, thank you for doing that, the more you do that, the more they feel good about where they are in the whole story, and then they're more likely to say the same thing back. Now, it does happen. He's saying it. His idea of support is, well, I hope that will work. He's not saying I don't think it'll work, but he's saying I hope that'll work. That's a that in his idea, that is actually positive in his thinking. Even though it's not to me, it is to him. So now I look for ways to be grateful for everything he does, and then it starts me off in a better place too, doesn't it? Starts you off in a better place rather than, oh, he said that. That feels bad. You don't want to go down that road or it hurts your business. So I hope this has been helpful to you, just a quick thought this morning. I'll give you some more techniques and strategies this afternoon. I just passed 2,000 followers, and do follow me, connect with me in Facebook, and I'm going to also how you can connect with me in Facebook right here. That is the username on Facebook. I will accept your friendship absolutely. Let's connect. I can help you with your marketing, no matter what company you're in. And we will help you do whatever it is you want to do, because I want to support everybody, whoever's in business. I'm not trying to change you into my company. I have things that will help you no matter what you're doing. And let's have an awesome day, everybody. And I'll be coming back in the evening with some more marketing ideas to help you out. And I hope that's been helpful. Thanks so much for all of the attendance. I will definitely connect with you. And let's talk some more. Bye for now.